what we keep telling you, the issue of abandoning the line of the NRA, the National Resistance Army, is the one which causes all these unnecessary delays and in some cases setbacks. It seems one of the suspect factors in that incident could be again corruption by some of these new players in the army who don't have the NRA spirit of patriotism, and they start looking at, because in Somalia the UN gives allowances, big allowances. Somebody told me that somebody may get about 38 million shillings in a year when they are deployed there. Now, some of these people, they don't look at the mission, they look at the money. So, but the investigation will go on and see, but one suspect thing is that because Somalia is a very dangerous place, if you go there like that, you end up with a bad situation for yourself. Now, because of the money, it seems some of our people are selecting people to go to Somalia. They don't do what we were doing at the beginning, apparently. I was not following. Because in the beginning, we would get combat units, brigade, this. It goes as a brigade and does the work. That's how they defeated Al-Shabaab in all those areas, in Mogadishu and all over. We have never had any big problem with Al-Shabaab because we are very capable. So they go as a fighting unit. But it seems at some stage, some of the people who organize, they put these bodyguards, secretary, I don't know what you call them, these who are around here, personal assistant, I don't know what. They put their names there, create sort of ad hoc, instead of having integral units, they create ad hoc groups made of bodyguards, made of what? People from cooks. They say this is now, I think that battalion was called Zuru, it is Battalion Zuru. Now, these people, because Al-Shabaab was very weak, had been weakened, it has not been attacking for a long time, and they couldn't attack a defense of NRA, of UPDF, it is suicidal. But because of that problem of sending welfare cases on a combat mission, we suspect that could be one of the problems. Of course, there can also be other problems, like because the attack started at what you call in your English way, 5, 10 past 5, when it was still dark. Now, if people are not well prepared, fighting in the dark can also be another problem. They can just panic for no reason. And yet, there is a way we fight in the dark, it's a well-known way. But Al-Shabaab will pay. The Americans, we don't have big support forces there, like Air Force and long-range artillery and so on. They have light equipment, which was doing well. But the Americans have some UAVs there, which should help, but I don't know what they are doing. They came for a little while and then went back. And then the Turkish also have some system there, UAVs. If they were all coordinating, there would be no problem, but they don't. So I was speaking with those people there, Major General Okiding, who is the force commander, and another brigadier called Brigadier Omola. And I was telling them that if the Turkish and the Americans don't want to support our ground forces, we shall support them ourselves. We shall find a way of intervening more decisively, like we did with ADF. ADF is crushed here in Congo. But this business of not listening to the NRA, because Uganda would never have come up to here if we had the mercenary attitude of selfishness, of money, of what. But of course, it's a good lesson for our people. They are going to wake up. We are sorry about the death, but it is because of, it's not Al-Shabaab, it is our internal weaknesses, which must be addressed.